Hello everyone, and welcome to a Strixhaven traditional draft. And I think it's gonna be the Kianne slash Imbraham, because both are good in their respective colors. So of course in a blue-green deck, or Quandrix, you can choose whichever you want to have in there, depending on the situation. But even I would play the Kianne in any green deck, and in Imbraham in any blue deck. So this is also a very, I mean, it's kind of like a hybrid card in that sense. Maybe even, you know, easier to cast because it has only one green color requirement, although it's a double caster blue. But no matter what, it's gonna be the pick here. While Memory Lapse is good, it's not as good as the rare here, and uncommons and commons don't really match here, so let's take the Kianne slash Imbraham. And then there are two very good options. Well, let's say, okay, well, not that I just saw the entire pack, this is just crazy good. So what was taken here? It wasn't the mystical archive card. It was an uncommon, actually. So the uncommon was taken because this is the kind of an extra uncommon here. Every draft pack has three uncommons, and the mystical archive card also always replaces a common slot. So someone took a common over, sorry, uncommon over Vanishing Verse, divide by zero, Mage Duel, Humiliate. I have no idea what that card could have been. I mean, they are very good uncommons in this set, so it might have been a very much reasonable pick, but what should I take here? There's also Field Trip, which is the best common here, and the Rise of Exodus is very close to that, I think. I don't think I take the Verse because of my first pick. I mean, these are good enough. I mean, Divide by Zero and Mage Duel, it's either of those. I think this is a learn card. But Mage Duel can be a one mana removal spell. It is really valuable. It was a tough choice, but if someone takes a Divide by Zero there, I definitely say that it's completely acceptable pick. It was so close between those two. I just like that when you get to cast this for one mana, and it's not gonna be, you know, tough to make this a one mana spell, it can be such a tempo boost. But the fact that Divide by Zero has Learn attached to it, it's of course pretty nice. And then there were the two black white cards, the rare, the exile target, monocolor permanent, and then there was of course the Humiliate, but obviously out of those two the rare is better. But yeah, Mage Duel was my pick there, and I could take the Sciences, I could take a Heated Debate here. It's between those two. Yeah, I'll take the Sciences now. Heated Debate is very good, but Sciences is very good too. And these picks don't kind of put me to red. But it is a very splashable card, so it definitely could be red. I mean, not be red, but I could pick the Heated Debate even when I'm not red. If I'm like a green something, I could just splash for it. But yeah, let's go to this pack. I took the Environmental Sciences, and that was that. This pack is pretty easy, Killian. Completely, you know, doesn't fit my first two picks, but although it does fit the Environmental Sciences, because this will be useful no matter what my deck ends up being. But the next best card in this pack is just something. I mean, the next best card that would fit with my first two picks here, it's like I don't know what it is. It's nothing here. Killian is the pick here. If black and, I mean, this is also some kind of signal. This is for pick four, Killian, and this thing is a first pickable card. So if black and white is open here, I'm definitely just moving that direction. And I'm getting here Necrotic Fumes, Lash of Malice, and a Humiliate. Also a Heated Debate, but I think it's not going to be a Heated Debate. So I guess Silverquill just is going to be open here. There's also an Arcane Subtraction and a Reckless Amplimancer for the blue and green. But if I'm going to be past the Killian and then a Humiliate, that has to mean that black and white will be open. So I'll take Humiliate, which is a fantastic card. Okay. Yeah, you know what? I guess you don't have to be like a master drafter to identify what's open, but this is such a funny thing because the pack didn't have to have a closing statement. I not only found the open archetype, but I was lucky enough that the packs that people opened, they had these black and white uncommons here. There were back to pack uncommons that were passed to me. Killian and then Humiliate and then a closing statement, all of which are crazy good, and also the Eye, which is fantastic, but obviously not gonna be a better at than a closing statement. But I really got lucky here. Yeah, I mean just get rid of these green cards. Who cares? This is gonna be a silver quill. And I have even a choice, a Dispark and Mage Hunter. I mean, it's not really a choice because Dispark is a better card, but Mage Hunter, I found it to be a very good card. And this is a best of three draft, so the Fracture would be a nice sideboard card, but obviously not gonna be picked over anything like a Mage Hunter or a Dispark here. Let's take the Dispark obviously here and see what else gifts I'm given here still. Alright, well, Expanded Anatomy is just amazing. Also very good with Killian because this makes it a 1-mana card. So I suppose the option is like an X spell for sideboard, but yeah, let's obviously take the lesson here, which is very good. Now, I'm not a fan of this Tenured Incaster, although with black and white, that is the kind of color combination that can benefit from the +1/+1 counter synergies the most, but there's still the Spirit Summoning, which I just think is the better choice. If I'm playing, almost likely playing white, black and white here, and this is a castable summoning here, and it's my first creature making lesson, so I think that's gonna be the pick over the 5 drop. Alright, I guess I can just take the Humil. I had this, I could have picked this from the pack if I, you know, didn't choose otherwise based on my first pick, but I could have taken this. But I'll take another Humiliate here, and this is just maybe, this is potentially one of those very crazy drafts where black and white is completely open. I'm gonna get all the black and white cards even as late picks because no one else is drafting the archetype. Stonerise Spirit versus Defiant Strike versus Professor's Warning. All of these are fine. I have only one creature here, but I think I like the Defiant Strike out of these options most. I could take the 2 drop though, but maybe I'll take the Defiant Strike. And go blank Defiance. I don't want to have too many cards that target my creatures because I have one creature only now, but go blank is like a sideboard card that won't often be used, so maybe I'll take the Beaming Defiance here. Duress is a fine sideboard card, and Unwilling Ingrid is a card I could play. Let's put it here. I have 2 Humiliates. I don't think I want to main deck the Aegis Guardian, so I put that to the sideboard. But with double Humiliate, starting with an Unwilling Ingredient and then turn 2 Humiliate, that's actually fantastic. You get to get rid of their most troublesome card, or just, you know, mess up with their mana curve, and then you get a 2/2 Menace guy. So that's fantastic reason to play the Ingredient here. I don't like the Strict Proctor that much as 2-mana 1/3 flyer. It's not really stat wise, it isn't that great. It's not that bad either. It's a playable card, and I don't think I'm gonna hurt myself with the ability. Permanent Entering the Battlefield trick. I don't think that really affects my deck currently, but I think the Umbral Duke just is the better card here, so I'll take that. And, well, I have completed the set, so I don't have to worry about this mythic rest. This is only 40 gems now, whereas there are, I mean, I would take the, even the Silverquill Campus over the time warp. The question is, do I take a Necrotic Fumes or Hunt for Specimens over the Campus here? The thing with Hunt for Specimens is that I'm not that big of a fan of the card in a black and white deck. I really like it in the Witherbloom black and green deck. I think I'll take the Campus here, actually, because I want to have the mana fixing here. And well, the Necrotic Fumes is going to be good too, but I think I'll take the mana fixing. Okay, so here, well, there's also some good green stuff. Medina, Master Symmetrist, very good cards. Leyland Invocation, definitely not a joke either. So. But the decision for me here is obviously Lash of Malice, Arrogant Poet, and Guiding Voice. And I think I have no learn card yet. I have some nice lessons. Well, I have three lessons. Okay, that and one of them makes even a creature. So guiding voice could be interesting, but I think I still take the Lash of Malice. And I do realize I need creatures, but one mana removal spell. I do like to have one Lash of Malice in all of my black decks. So I'll take that now. Here it's going to be the Silverquill Pledge Mage, which I do like more than the Arrogant Poet, so let's take it. And so in this direction, okay, I have the Master Symmetry. Someone is going to get all this good green stuff. But in this direction, the black and white is not that open. But I'm assuming at pack 3 it could be. Although that this can also mean that someone really noted the same as I, that it's completely open. Someone might go on black and white here. Also, they might have opened some bomb rare from black and white. But here, there's nothing else for me than the Star Pupil, so let's take it. I can play it with the double Humiliate, it's actually quite fine. And the Dueling Coach is not bad. The Pest Summoning would be good too, but I have no learn cards. So, and I have three lessons already, so that's not really a high priority. Juke, Rescue, Campus. I take another Juke, I think it's a fantastic one. And here it can be the Stone Rise Spirit. Now this is already 15 non-lands, so I don't think I'm gonna run out of playables here. How are these mage duels? I have an environmental sciences, so there's a chance I can actually, if I actually got some learn cards, I have none of them yet, but if I can get them, I could even splash mage duels. Maybe not in the main deck, but after sideboarding I might decide to do that. I don't like the essence infusion. I really don't. It's just so unreliable. Sometimes it can just win the game, but when the opponent gets the kill the or somehow deal with the creature you enhance with it, it's just such a bad feeling. Why is Mortality Spear here? Now this would actually be a very good spot to splash the green, but I don't have the fixing here. That's the problem. I have the environmental sciences, but I don't have the learn cards. So I sadly can't do that. But I take the Necrotic Fumes, it's a nice lesson to be having access to. But I really now want to actually find the learn cards. Even a Cram Session is probably a card I might consider running thanks to my lesson toolbox. But it was very tempting to take the Mortality Spear and play the Mage Duels, but I also do need creatures, not removal here. Although I have a double Umbral Juke, so this 6 creatures lies a bit, because I do in fact have access to 8 creatures here. I don't know what to take here. I'm never going to play the Revitalize, so I'll take the Dina. I'm not going to move to black-green, but this would have been also a very good black-green deck. It seems like green was pretty open here too. At least black-green was open. But hopefully I get some nice Silverquill cards in pack 3. I don't need them a lot. Basically only 8. And I can still play stuff like Ageless Guardian in the main deck. Not a great thing to do, but I have a double Humiliate, so they can all act at least grow to be a 2/5 creature, which can, you know, attack for 2. Although it's incredibly easy to block a 2 power creature, but anyway. It's something I can do if I do run out of playables. Why is the Mage Duel here? I don't know if I'm supposed to pick it or the Academic Dispute. I'll take the Mage Duel. Maybe I'll sideboard into all the Mage Duels. It's very unlikely, but who knows. Okay. So something good black and white. Heated debate number 1,000,000 in here. There's a learn card. Well, I'm gonna take that. Also, there's not really anything else here. I guess there's a Witherbloom Campus, which would help with the potential black splash. Green splash, but let's take the first learn card here. It's also nice with the Star Pupil and the Unwilling Ingredient, so definitely has some synergy. Well, Killian number 2. Is there a question what I pick here? No. I would like to have a Lich Fanatic, Pledge Mage, and maybe even another of these anatomies, but this is obviously Killian. It is just a very good card. 2/2 with Menace and Lifelink, and well, that's already like more than you ever get from a 2-drop. This is a legendary creature, so I can't cast I mean, I can't have both of these at the same time, but even if I have just one on the battlefield, it's gonna be very nice. And this has the, you know, the even the, you know, the second, well, is it the third ability, I guess, the spell to cast a target a creature cost 2 less, so closing statement is gonna be cheaper. I guess it doesn't actually affect that much in this deck. Defiant Strike and Guiding Voice is not gonna get a discount. Beaming Defiance will get the discount. Humanoid doesn't target a creature, although it would be able to get a discount because it has no generic mana in the mana requirement. This doesn't target a creature. So I suppose this ability doesn't do a whole lot. But it's still, I mean, just because it's a lifelink and many creature 2-2 makes it very good. Okay, so now I can finally get the pack, and there's a flunk and not a ton of other stuff. I would want to have the study break. I could play the Pillar Drop Rescuer, but let's just take the flunk, which is a fantastic removal spell. Okay, so it takes some time to get those packs, so maybe at this point I should remind that if you are new to my channel, I do upload daily draft videos. So every day there will be published a new draft video, at least one, sometimes two, but probably mostly one in June. So please, if you are interested in this kind of content, please consider subscribing to my channel. That is a nice way to kind of support the channel. It's a pretty small channel, so I do appreciate all the help I can get. But also, if you don't care about this content, don't subscribe, because I don't know, maybe I shouldn't say this, but I feel like I want that most of my subscribers, or I guess I want that most of all my subscribers are people who at least occasionally check some of my videos. So if you are not gonna check my videos in the next 6 months, maybe don't subscribe. But if you are genuinely interested in this draft content, please drop a subscribe. It doesn't cost you anything. Here I might just take the creature. Defend the campus seems very unnecessary because I have some nice removal here already, so let's just take the other white card in here. And here there's an eliminate. But the other, I don't have any. I guess that this deck would have want to have some actual, you know, significant sized creatures. The creature base in this deck is very bad. But I can't help it. I'm not gonna take a third spirit, a two power Dusk Mage. Clever Lumimancer. Now I'll take the eliminate and hope to get some, at least some creatures here still. I guess I'm I was saying that maybe I take the spirit summoning, but I have only one learn spell here. I think it's gonna be the study break, but this seems bad. I'll take the study break, but I actually need creatures here. And here, okay, why does this pack have Silverquill, Pledge Mage, Mage Hunter, and Owling Shield Mage? Couldn't these creatures have been spread, between the earlier two earlier packs and this one? I would have taken all of these over the cards I picked there. So here, I do like. I guess I'll take the Shield Mage over the Mage Hunter. This flies. So, but Mage Hunter would be very good too. And now another pack that doesn't have anything than a promising Dusk Mage. I know it's okay with the Guiding Voice and Star Pupil, double Humiliate, and also the Closing Statement. I have ways to keep it a counter, so I'll take it, but mostly I take it because it's a creature and I need those things. Also, there's the Dueling Codes. Heated Debate, pick number 9. Okay, I'll take it just because it's not supposed to be there. Divine Gambit, I can sideboard it in if I need yet another removal spell. I don't think I want to main deck it. It's a bit risky one, and I have a lot of a lot of removal here already. Do I have any early drops here? Oh, there's a Rip Apart. There's a Cram Session, but I think now because I'm at 23 levels, I don't think I'm going to cut anything to fit in a Cram Session. So let's take the Rip Apart. Plot Researcher, sure. I might actually play the another. Oh, look at this. Pick 14, Rip Apart. I don't know what the. Was everyone forcing? I don't know what happened here. Actually, like Prismari or something. It doesn't matter. Also, the heated debate was so late here. So red wasn't that much drafted. Whatever. Yeah, this sideboard is going to remain as the sideboard. So let's see the lessons, which are now one creature, one removal, one mana fixing, and you know, just getting additional land and expanded anatomy. So four cards, but I think I have two learn cards, so it's kind of, you know, good enough for all that. Yeah, and I have one card to make, unless I want to play. I could play 16 lands in the deck. I have a canvas to help my colored costs a bit, and I also have the environmental sciences that I can get with the one drop or the two drop learn card. So I think if I cut here, just one land, that would be it. Very even amount of white and black here. So let's see which is gonna be, because now it's 9 and 9. Cutting a land will mean that I will have a little fewer of the other one, but this is very even here. I don't really know what should I take here. I mean, it's just a, I have one drop creatures for both colors. I have one mana other spells for both colors. My two drops want to have both white and black. I guess there's the double stone rise spirit, but then my three drops want to have black. It's really just impossible to say which one is the card I should cut here. Maybe I'll take I don't know. Maybe there's like a very small, slightly higher chance that I want to play. I have a three white one mana spells, only two black one mana spells, so maybe I'm a bit more likely to need two white, let's say on turn three, than two black. So let's cut a swamp here, but that's very close. But the 16 land seems very, you know, reasonable for this deck. I don't have any heavy hitters, I suppose. I just try to use my small creatures and my removal to push some damage through. I have the Novice Dissector here, which it's bad enough to not play in the main deck, but it's also a card I could sideboard in if I, you know, just need a random 4 mana 3/3. I can cut something like a Defiant Strike to make room for it. That said, I could actually just do it already. There's like a very little bit of synergy with the Dusk Mages, but there's not a lot of sacrifice fodder here. Maybe I'll play the Defiant Strike. Okay, this is my main deck, but I could consider sideboarding this thing in. Alright, let's play. I'm not gonna make any splashes here. This is fine deck. Okay, 2-drop, 3-drop removal, both colors. Fantastic hand. Could be, because this deck has a pretty low mana curve, I guess I could flood out if I, let's say in the next next 5 draws, if 3 of them or more of them, more than 3, 3 or more of them are lands, that could be bad. Because I don't have any kind of big creatures here, so there's no 5/5s or anything. The kind of highest impact creature in this deck is the Oling Shield Mage, a 5 mana 3/3 flyer. And that's about it. So I can't really survive any big floods. And that's the first card is a land, so let's say. If 3 out of 5 cards are lands, I say I'm in trouble. So 1 out of 1 is also land. It will hunt for a specimen. So I guess the edict mode won't be that good here. Killian. Yeah, I can play Killian here. Oh, flank will be a one mana spell now thanks to Killian. But yeah, okay, 1 out of 2 was a land, so that was good. That I didn't draw another land. They are thinking, do they want to play the summoning here or something else, perhaps? Mage too. Well, I have the flank for that, so that's all fine. Okay, so attack here and I can get out the... at least it was the Skryland, but two out of three were land drops. Land draws, I mean. Deny. Can I make them sacrifice that? Or I can make myself. Okay then. The problem is that they have the Inkling summoning, they can't just, you know, play to block the 2-1 flyer here. I can make them sacrifice a creature here. I don't want them to sacrifice that as the 2-1, but I guess it's gonna be what they want to do. I mean, of course they can sacrifice also the D9 here, but this has menace anyway. I would have played the flyer otherwise, but they have their own flyer to deal with it, so I just want to at least gain life when I attack with my 2 power thing. Because I wasn't gonna attack with the Killian otherwise. I guess my deck has a bunch of removal, so I could have kind of hoped to get a removal spell. Well, Study Break is good too, but the, actually my creature isn't going to be... it needs 2 white, so if I cast this, I can't cast the Spirit Summoning, so I will wait what they're doing there. I can also get the Expanded Anatomy, but that's way too risky. If they have a removal on the Killian, I don't want to make this any bigger, and I would rather have another threat. Okay. Well, that's slightly awkward. So... the Spirit doesn't do anything against the Dina here. They have only one card I don't know about. If I make the Killian a 4-4, they still can double block it. Fine, I still take it. Oh, got the Shield Mage, which I can't even cast. Oh, I should keep the... should I keep the Shield Mage the counters, actually? Huh. But the Shield Mage is gonna be good anyway if they have a removal for it. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do it like this. Killian also can, you know, attack for 4 right now instead of 2. And I think it is going to be a good blocker on the stuff here. But my reasoning here is that currently they're only flying, you know, they have 1-2-1 blocker for this thing, but it's not going to be enough to kill the Shield Mage. So if they have a removal spell, I don't want them to use it on the 5-5 flyer, because the 3-3 flyer will be a good threat here anyway. They get their own expanded anatomy, okay? But for them, it costs the full mana. Full amount of mana. So they have a decision between the anatomy, Inkling, or maybe the third card they have available. Seems like a mage duel, actually. No, it wasn't. Okay, that is... definitely I'm gonna block here. I mean, why wouldn't I do that? D-spark. Oh! immediately draw the thing here. It doesn't actually target. Can't target those things, but I'm still winning the race easily. And I have the scry up, so it's not that bad. But of course, if I knew I'm gonna draw this, I would have never blocked there. they have more than... it seems like they're playing two colors. Why would they be playing two campus guides in a black and green deck? Maybe they just need two drops, it's possible. Guiding Voice is gonna get me maybe there. But it's gonna make this a 4-4. I suppose I'm gonna play this. It's not the greatest card actually. It's gonna give me the 3-2, but the 3-2 is bad against the 2-4 and bad against the 2-1-2. Can't even cast it right away. But then if my next draw is like a land, it's a tough one. I guess I'll keep it because it could just make my flyer bigger here. So I'm gonna do it. And even though that means I can't steal... I can't cast it because, you know, I don't have the double white here now. But I will have this cry up. So there is that. But the opponent is attacking me with 6, but I'm at 27 here. I'm not worried about that. But I can scry on at the end of turn, and then if nothing else, I can play the spirit, which will decrease their clock a bit. Okay, so they have a third color. They just always had the blue there, or they just didn't want to get it because they had no blue card. But I'm winning this race, of course. Well, unless they have something. They have the Dina activation, but it's not really relevant right now. And that's a 3 mana spell, can't be dealt with as D-Spark. Now this would have been a completely different game if I didn't block the Aincaster and use the D-Spark. But now they are at least, you know, having a... No, they are top decking here. So this is gonna win the game in a couple of attacks. Well, 3 attacks to be precise, but... And I have the spirit summoning here to kind of buy me some time, and I also, well, I have the eliminate here now too, and the scry land if I run out of things to play. So there's no reason to play the eliminate right now. I will just play the spirit, and then the eliminate will be kept up in here. So currently they have 8 power. And they can sacrifice creatures to make this thing, you know, but it doesn't add to their power to the board. It's only to kind of to transfer the power from somewhere else to Dina. So there's no... I mean, I can take 8 here, and I actually have a... Oh, well, that's fantastic. Now, it does mean, of course, that they will get to eat the thing with Dina. But it doesn't matter. I get a nice 2-for-1 here anyway. And, they're gonna make Dina now a 4 power creature. But I can even just block the campus guide if I want to, and I probably will. And they will have to... Well, let's see, I mean, if they attack with all, of course... Well, they first of all, they can't attack with all, because I have 7 power here. So they have to leave a blocker here, no matter what. Probably the campus guide, yeah. So I'm not gonna jump there, I take 6, dropping to 15, it's completely fine, of course. And let's see what they draw here. That's a good one. No reason to trade with the campus guide here, I don't think. So let's just attack here. Have the pupil and actually also the scry up. They still have one turn with the inkling jump block, even if they don't draw anything. And they drew a land and they showed it to me, giving me all the information I can ever need. Yep, that's gonna be good enough. So... Well, they're gonna have to jump block with the flyer anyway. So who's gonna get the counter? I can give the counter to the spirit. But they can make the Dina a 4, because they will jump this anyway. The Dina is effectively a 4-4 here now. So... I'm gonna give it maybe to the star pupil after all. I could keep it, I can kind of force the block with Dina, it's not that bad, actually. I mean, the shield mage is most likely going to be lethal here anyway. Okay, I don't have to attack with this thing either. I mean, I can just make all of these guys gain a counter thanks to the dueling code. So maybe I'll do it like this. Because now they just need an answer for this, and removal doesn't work. At least spot removal, because they would have to pay all the life they have left. So a flying blocker or a mass removal. So this opponent also plays Essence Infusion. Well, as was showcased in here, the eliminating response just gave me a free 2-for-1, so that is a really risky card to be playing. I have a bunch of removal here, so I don't worry about them getting essence infusions up. How about the Beaming Defiance? Do they have a spot removal? They have a Lash and Mage Duel. I guess that might be enough to still keep it. Because if I cut it, or I guess I could cut the Defiant Strike and put the Novice Dissector just to have like another random 4-drop here, even though it's very unexciting. Maybe. Is this a Defiant Strike going to be that great? The only Magecraft trigger in the deck is the Pledge Mage, and I suppose I have a bunch of triggers for it anyway. So. I could see cutting maybe the Defiant Strike, because it didn't seem it's gonna be that relevant to have the one additional power here against them, maybe. So let's play the Dissector. It's not great, but let's play it anyway. Okay, nice hand. Oh, I drew the land, which is nice. They could have a Lash of Malice here, but I'm not gonna, miss my 2-drop here. Dino is there. So they might go for the double block, and I can't punish them. I can make them sacrifice before I attack, which I might do actually. I could Guiding Voice, but they still can double block there, so no point in doing that. Let's make them sacrifice. I don't care which one they're gonna sack. They can't block the Mini Sky after that. Okay, well, if they don't have a creature, that's just Essence Infusion showing. Yeah, they could have in theory, they could have the Baroque Befuddler. But, could they have a bounce spell? No, I'm gonna play Guiding Voice here. Because I'm gonna want to play the Umbral Juke here also. And this time it's going to be the spirit. And they could have a test of talents. How about an instant? I guess I'm gonna do this in their upkeep. If they have a test of talents, I want them to tap mana on their turn instead. Or a negate. Negate can be there too. Like so. So that was Essence Infusion backfiring again. And that's. I can't actually despug that thing, it's funny. But I can, just attack with my three power lifelink menace thing here and win the race here this way. And I could play the coach. Although. I don't necessarily want to pump the coach itself. Maybe I want to pump the spirit here. That's it. No, spirit is double white, so I mean it's even though the coach is better for mana efficiency, I have 4 mana available, but this is double white, so if I draw like a swamp, spirit is still going to mean that it's the only spell I can cast. So let's play the spirit. They also know about that thing. So they're gonna raise here, which means they need either 2 blockers or removal here, and they do have the 2 blockers here instead. Understandably. So, of course I have things I can do, including study break. Tap both of those. Or I could play... Because study break is actually 1 mana card here, thanks to Killian. It doesn't show it in here. I guess because I can also target just my own creatures, so it's not always gonna be a 1 mana spell. It's only 1 mana spell if I target at least one of their creatures. But I feel like I'm gonna play the dueling coach here, and then on their turn use the study break. I can also just actually attack with this thing. I can. I will definitely give the counter on this spirit here. And if they block with the biocroft, that's not so bad for me. That's a fine trade. They don't even block there. Okay. And I will obviously let them attack if they want to attack. I'm at 24, don't care about that. And they had nothing, because now what would have happened next? Dueling coach starts to pump both of these things. Alright, that was a match won. Okay, I have 2 Killians in the deck, so I guess it's not that unlikely to get those on turn 2, but it is definitely very good when you do. Of course, there are 1 mana and 2 mana removals in this set to deal with it before it gets to even connect. But when they don't deal with it, it's gonna connect. I mean, it's gonna just drain like 4 life very easily in 2 attacks, especially when I want to play like here. So I do have the flank for that thing. So the question is, do I wanna flank that thing and play the Duke as a creature, or I can just make them sacrifice it? I guess I will not have to make the decision right now. I feel like I want to have the flyer and then I can just flank this thing. Oh well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so flank doesn't work now, so let's make them sacrifice it. But why are these opponents playing Essence Infusion? This is just a... I mean, that was like a third time in a row when opponent just gives me a 2 for 1 in there. Insane. I don't get it. I mean, it's a very risky card to be playing, especially when the opponent has cards in their hand. I mean, of course, it's not risky when they don't have a card in their hand. Alright, whatever. Don't have to worry about it. They actually are even missing land drops, so that might just be this game. Right there, given that I have this amount of creatures here and these spells in my hand. Okay, humiliate. Let's see what they have and wrap this up. So they have 3 mana now. They might draw land for a 4th, so there's like a... The flank will not be dealing much here, because they will be at like a... It will be like a -1/-1. The Duskmage doesn't do anything. Master Symmetrist and the Spectre will block a flyer. The Woe Eater won't do anything either. Karok is annoying because it can start gaining them life, but I don't think it's gonna be fast enough. I'm gonna give the counter, I think, to the Stone Rise Spirit. They don't have actually any interaction. I should maybe just get rid of the Master Symmetrist. Yeah, because if they play draw land and play the Spectre, this being a 2-3 means that Defiant Strike is gonna be, you know, killing the Spectre. So I will get rid of the Master Symmetrist and give the counter on the Stonerise Spirit. And now they're actually losing next turn. Unless they find a land and play the Spectre here. Or if they drew a removal. Okay, they find a land, so they need to have the Spectre because this Karok can't block any of these things. They have to play Spectre, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so they will have... Okay, this flank won't be lethal, which means that they will get to survive. Oh, they actually won't, because I can just Defiant Strike the Killian order. Yeah, they can't survive here. They can't survive, because I will get to deal 6 here no matter what. They block the Stonerise Spirit, and then I will just play the Defiant Strike on... one of my unblocked things. Let's give it to the Killian so I get to get another life point here. But yep. It was very easy when I was able to 2-for-1 when they played the infusion. Now I have lost to essence infusion, but whenever I have lost to them, I have said, definitely have said that if I just had removal, they would have, you know, the opponent would have been in such a bad shape. But then when I didn't have removal, I was in the bad shape. So that's like a incredibly high variance card, and that's definitely not something I want to count on in my games. I don't want to count on the opponent not having interaction. I just want to play cards that, you know, don't, you know, blow me out. Well, how do you say? Don't cause me big trouble if opponent happens to have something that decks generally do have, like removal spells. Alright, so what is the sideboarding stuff? I think the with the Master Symmetrist, I want to be able to push through. So the Guiding Voice will become... or will it actually... No. I actually was remembering my previous deck. I could have the... this, you know, Guiding Voice goes never... this is the learn card. Actually, I played this back-to-back with the previous draft, if you see that I... you know, published the day before. This is, I mean, I just played the draft like an hour ago, so I actually remember that that deck. I had the sideboard a decision to, you know, sideboard out a Guiding Voice and put a red, the Enthusiastic Study in. But yeah, that doesn't apply here. So here I could take the Novice Dissector in, but that's just bad. So how about the Divine Gambit? It's very risky though. But the Master Symmetrist is very good against me. And also, if the Essence Infusion up something, I could play the Divine Gambit. Okay, I actually am gonna do it. Defiant Strike goes away, Divine Gambit goes in. Let's try how it works. I don't think the Novice Dissector is gonna be that great here. So I'm not gonna play sideboard that in. Hey, where's my Killian? Where's my 2-drop? Well, there's an Eliminate as a 2-drop. So, currently there's no synergy for these things, but maybe I find one of my many synergies for it. I should just eliminate it before they get the counter for it, and I can play my own Dusk Mage, which may or may not get some counters at some point. That wasn't a bad draw. They have nothing. There's the Symmetrist, and it's gonna be only... okay, flank is gonna be only a 3... minus 3, minus... two. Oh, no, minus 2, minus 2. So definitely... No, but it is actually going to be good enough, because, of course, it's gonna be a 2-2 only. So let's play the Guiding Voice for this thing. And I guess the Expanded Anatomy... no, let's play the Spirit, actually. And if they block, it's gonna be good for me. If they don't block, I can play the Spirit. Post-combat. and they choose to go for the block. Mage Hunter. No longer can. No, I'm gonna tap it and get the. Yeah, I'm gonna do it. I guess I should maybe go to the end step. So let's do this, and I'm gonna get the expanded anatomy here. And I can now cast both the spirit and the expanded anatomy here. Like so. Losing life doesn't matter here much. But now if they can, well, I guess if they just kill this without exiling it, I get to draw a card. But this is not that great. I need some removal now. They are at 8. They can still gain life with this, you know. Black and green has a lot of life gain effects, and they have 6 cards in their hand. I have only a land, so I need to draw, you know, actual business here. Yeah, I've drawn 6 non-lands and 7 lands here. Okay, so that's gonna draw me a card, that's fine. That's the card being a land is not fine. But, okay, ingredient will actually be relevant here. So definitely I'm just gonna attack with this because they're gonna, not gonna block these, they would eat the 3-2, but having the ingredient here is not bad. It has menace, by the way. I mean, that's the reason it's not bad, because it has menace, and they are only at 4, so they will have some difficulty trying to make some blocks. So they're missing land here. But of course they are at 4. They have both colors available, even for double casters. So do they just not have any cheap creatures? Okay, that is yeah, sure. Let's see if I attack with all. Yeah, well that would be super bad. Let's not do that. They can block them. Eat the Duskmage. And eat the 3-2, and they take 1 damage. And they're gonna get life here, because they're gonna, of course, sacrifice this. They're not gonna sacrifice the Mage Hunter. I will discard one of the Plains cards. I could attack with the ingredient and draw a card. Now, that is not a bad idea, but I think I would rather just wait for that. And I'll let them, they will gain 2 life here too. But they still need to get a good blocker for the Duskmage. I guess they could have like a Witherbloom Pledge Mage. Oh, they chose. What? Why would they. I don't understand. Why would they sacrifice the Mage Hunter here? Do they have some kind of win plan here? I have no idea. Because they, of course, have to sacrifice something on the next turn too. Ah, that's so bad for them. They just sacrificed the creature for no reason. That's so bad for them. I mean, I do the same thing. I play my creature. And no point attacking here. Let's see what they sacrifice now. Okay, now they choose that. So they gain life, I will discard this one, and they draw another card, but now the 7-6 is no longer there, so they need to have something for the Duskmage. But like I said, they could have a Witherbloom Pledge Mage, which can block the Dusk Mage. And this has lifelink, so this can block. Okay, well, that's not a Witherbloom Pledge Mage. Do they have something? Oh, Essence Infusion. Alright, alright. You can have that. I can have... Well, I don't have mana to activate it twice, but I can attack for 4 here. But I can attack also for 3 in here, because I have to... Because they have the Moldering Karok in here. It might be a better idea to attack with 3 here. And then leave the Dusk Mage as a blocker here. Because I would rather eat it. And if they have some trick, this dies, I get to draw a card anyway. Okay, that doesn't help them. That blocks a flyer, but it's probably not that... Yeah, it's not... Oh, Lash of Malice. Well, that is, I think... So I'm gonna make 2 of these guys fly. They would have to block them both. Oh, this will fly also with the trigger. Okay, that's easy then. That flies. So now they don't have enough. Because I have enough lethal attackers here and they are tapped out, so it's very easy. Yeah, that's what I like with the Pledge Mage. Very nice to guess. Okay, Killian, turn 2 with all the mana, and you know, the other cards aren't that bad either, so very easy keep. Also on the draw, on the play, this is gonna be great, unless they have a Lash of Malice here now. Okay. Well, even if they have a Lash of Malice, first of all, I think they would have used it right away, because now they let me untap, I could have a, you know, something to save it. So I don't think they have a Lash of Malice. So I have no other creatures to give the counter to, and even if they have a removal here, I get to discard a card from there. So let's do it. They can have just an Arcane Subtraction here. That's what they have. So Burying Books. Well, this will learn them something anyway, so there's no point losing the subtraction. I will make them go get rid of the Burying Books, which makes my Killian actually, you know, they have nothing to deal with the Killian because their hand is just lands and this stuff. They get something from there, but I can't imagine it's anything too, you know, relevant here. It's some kind of creature. It's not a fractal token. Oh, they just chose to discard to draw. That's also completely fine. They just use the card to discard to draw. So basically, they discarded 2 cards to draw 1 card. Now the land was redundant, so but I mean it's definitely fine for me. That gets flunked immediately. They have 1 card I don't know about. So if they happen to draw, because this flunk is gonna be a -3/-3. And if they have a Magecraft trigger, that of course means they're, you know, it's gonna be -4/-4. But if that is a snakeskin whale, I'm gonna say that. It was very sad. Gladly, that wasn't the case. But sadly, I do draw only lands here. But I have the scry land here, so I can't scry now. But starting from next turn, I can start scrying. Okay, so they actually. Well, I'm gonna. Tap those things then, because I don't want to continue with the attacks. And do I want to play the Expanded Anatomy or the Spirit Summoning? Well, they can still double block the 5/5, so it's gonna be the Spirit. Main phase pop quiz. Why would they do it main phase? There's no two mana lesson. They could have done that on my turn too. Oh, sorry. Now I understand. That makes perfect sense. Alright, so... Right. Maybe I can get them with a juke. Depends on how they block here. That is fine. Definitely. So, I think I just want to have the flyer, in fact. Oh, I can't attack into the 4-4 with the 3-2, but it's not... It doesn't matter. I will draw a card. I still have the mana for the juke here. Maybe I draw something better. Okay, well, actually, I can actually attack into the 4-4 with the Divine Strike. If they choose to play it. And I will play the land that allows me to scry end of their turn. So they need to find the answer for the flyer, but they of course can do that. So, okay, that's not an answer to the flyer. Now they have only one card I don't know about, but they do have their own scry lands up here. They are splashing for black, or just playing, you know, scry lands. Scrylands that don't, you know, what a draw. That's a nice one. That's like the best creature. Not the best because Killian is, but the point was that in terms of, you know, the size and abilities, a 3-3 flyer is definitely one of the best cards you can have here. But it's possible they play blue-green, which has double up with the Bloom campus if they just want to have access to these Scrylands and they didn't get any Quandrix campuses. Anyway, there's a Scry to bottom here. That's of course always good news to see Scry to bottom. And that can block, and that's... Oh, wow. Now I'm sad. Now I'm very sad. Ah, oh, man. Well, I'm gonna attack with the Pupil and give the counters to the Shield Mage so that I can at least try to trade here. But this is gonna be very bad if they are able to find some answer here. But this is the only legit play I have available. How they scry now? Top. Oh man, that is so bad. Do I wanna scry? I think I wanna scry instead of playing this thing. It doesn't do anything as long as they have the blocker. I know it can block the Summoner, but I don't actually care about them attacking that much now. I just want to scry into a removal spot because I have a lot of them. But I'm very worried about this thing. Oh, well, they are splashing for black, and that is a good one, but it's not that great now with when they have an empty hand. Come on, removal. Nope. Alright, well. Now I can attack with both. The thing is that if they block the 2-1 here, they drop to 4. And then I can... No, it's not gonna work. I was kind of counting on this thing flying, but I have the trigger for it. But I would have to play both of these before my next turn, and then I don't have the flyer, so I have to just do it like this. I will have to offer the trade. It's sad, but that is how it goes. I can still win here. Definitely can still win here. Let's see how they scry now. Top. Oh, that is sad. I might actually be losing. I think I'm going to, in fact, block the 4-3 here. Keep this thing lifelink and get my flyer. again. Well, that still gives me lifelink, and they still trade, so they only basically covered my flyer, so I can still win, but I need help here. That's maybe helping. That is going to add, yeah, that's going to reduce a turn from my clock, so that is not, that is a good draw, and I also have the scry available, but so do they. Let's see if they actually scry to bottom right now, because I'm going to take here 6 damage now. Oh no, actually, I can't block the 1-1. That means that my clock is going to... That's going to increase to my clock if they gain 1 life there. Okay, now the scry was the bottom, that is good. And then we're going to upkeep scry, which leaves them 3 mana. And how do they decide here? If this is like a 4 mana spell or more expensive one, it's going to be awkward for them. They don't have a scry available and they can't cast that. Oh, actually they could cast 4 mana spell, I forgot the island. But anyway, they scry to bottom, so this is a random card now, which was just a land. So am I going to block the 1-1? I will scry first, that's definitely what I need to do here. Duskmage. It can block the island here, because this is a race here. And I also can make it fly here. So I'm gonna keep it on top. And because the Duskmage can, I can make it fly, and then you know that's gonna be 5 damage anyway. They're gonna go to 7 now. I think I'm doing this. Because of the Stone Rise Spirit doing some nice work here. I have now lethal for the next turn thanks to the spirit. And the Duskmage. They will upkeep scry. On bottom, good. So they have now 5 mana available with the island creature here. And that was not enough. Okay. Yeah, the Dragon's Guard Elite is very good. So they have Burying Books, they have Arcane Subtraction, Mage Duel, Negate. I feel like the Duress could be an interesting decision here. I think I'm gonna take the Duress in and maybe not play the Defiant Strike. There might be enough targets for the Duress. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna do anything else though. That's the sideboarding I'm doing here. Well, I'm not keeping a one lander here. This I can keep, and what is the cut though? Because I think the least, you know, yeah, it's gonna be the Duress. I mean, all the other cards I can still cast. Well, this only if I draw a land here. But this can basically just whiff too. There's no reason to cut anything, any of these, rather than the Duress. But I do need more creatures. The Duke can be a creature, and most likely will be. Okay, that's gonna get last of my list, right? There's like no way I'm not gonna kill this thing right away. Hopefully I draw a land. Okay, that's gonna get flunked though. Or actually, it's gonna get eliminated. I don't have a snakeskin whale. Oh man. Should I have flunked it? Because that was a possible thing they could have. At least the flunk is still a possibility, but problem is of course that they have a Sedgemoor Witch in here. Which is also, I mean, they drew both of their rares and they got the splash color on for turn 3. And now that they have the token here, that does mean that even if I drew the land, the juke wouldn't work here. Well, I'm having nothing here, so let's just go to game 3. I mean, what can I do here? I'm not drawing the land at all here. I will re-mulligan to 6. So let's try, maybe they don't get both of those things. And the snakeskin whale was the problem there. If they didn't have the snakeskin whale, I could have flunked the 3-2 they had on turn 3. And then I would have had more time to, you know, find my third land. Oh, come on. Again, one lander. I'm gonna keep it because I have now Killian and Lash of Malice here, and I'm not gonna go to five. This is both colors for me. So, Study Break can get me the environmental sciences, right? I have that here. I do. So... Dusk Mage can get a counter from the coach, but I think it's still going to be there. I don't know, I could. Now, Dusk Mage becomes bad if I drop the coach, so maybe I'll lose the Dusk Mage here. And now, if I draw land, everything is fine. If I don't draw, I have the Lash of Malice for the 2-drop, and then I just lose. Okay, good. But I still would have preferred to keep a 7-card hand, you know, with a reasonable amount of spells and lands, but at least I can kill again the land here. And I drew even another land. So it's kind of tempting to just play the juke, but I don't think I'm gonna do that. I will kill this just to prevent them from having the 4 mana available. And this is... Well, it was a swamp, but they already have black sauce in here. They have the witch. Well, I'm gonna kill that too. With the sacrifice. Having removal is nice, but... okay, I drew the other Dusk Mage, so I can play that, and I can coach it. Well, a D-Spark. Well, definitely. Let's go for it. Kill the 4-3. Sorry, both of them, actually. Funny. Problem is they still have, you know, all the cards in their hand. These were just fun for once. It was good for me, but it's still kind of awkward. And they have another one of those. I guess I could have a study break, but... Environmental sciences doesn't even... Because I want to play the Dusk Mage. So no, I'm not gonna study break it. There's no point. Yeah, they just drew two cards, so it's very tough to win here. Still, I did mulligan to six, but I was very lucky to draw the back-to-back lands. But their opponent is really—they are not gonna show any signs of, you know, giving up here. They just have a very good draw here. They got rid of my Killian, so I can't no longer gain any life here. At least I did draw the fourth land here, but let's see, they still have four lands here, so four cards, I mean, so it's not great. No blocks. Let's see if I draw the fifth land for the coach. I did, so I can't attack here. Well, actually I can, of course. If they have something, that would be bad, but let's see what they're gonna have. I guess if this dies, I still get burying books, because of course. Could I have please had the Beaming Defiance here? Yeah, that's just game over. I mean, I can't beat the Burying Books. Yeah, I have a 4 mana 2-2 here now after them having that. But they just had all they needed here. So do I want to... I guess I have to do this. Get like an expanded anatomy or something like that. Because that allows me to at least use the coach if I just end up drawing more land here. I give it the spirit some. I mean, I'm gonna of course lose to... Oh, well, that was a good one. So now it's an interesting question. Okay, I'm gonna actually just attack here for now. Maybe I will give the Dusk Mage the counters. Yeah, the other Killian was very good here now. They have their expanded anatomy. Can I afford to... They can make the Scurry colony a big one. Okay, let's see what happens. I'm not gonna play the expanded anatomy. As long as Killing survives, it's gonna be a one mana card anyway, and I know what I'm gonna draw. Alright, well, they just... They have the relevances. But I guess they have to give the Scurry colony the counters, because otherwise... I don't know, maybe I should have just gone for the Stone Rise, but it's, I might have made a mistake here. I made a mistake there. I kind of forgot that they can actually just raise me now. Because if I did this on the previous turn, to just cast the anatomy on the Stone Rise spirit here, it would have been so that they would be at 9 life at currently. And then this would be a 3-4 now. And I would have the 5 mana, to activate this, to make this a 4-5, so they couldn't block this unless they are willing to lose it. Now, on the other hand... I can keep the Killian... I guess I have to do it like this, because this gives me life. I will, because it has menis, so I can give it a, you know, life flying. So that I just hope that they don't have a way to deal with this thing. I still don't have a win for the next turn. So opponent has 2 attacks, which can be a problem. Can be a very big problem here, because they have a big creatures here. I have jump blocks, but I have only with the coach, I suppose. I can't lose block with the... But then again, if they're gonna attack with all, they don't have blockers, so... They can't attack with the all. And this is, by the way, a 6-6 now, because that was their 8 land. They still have 2 mana. 2 cards in their hand also. So that's gonna be like 10 damage. It's insane. I'm never gonna have mana to use this, so let's just block here. Block here and hope that they don't have a way to deal with the Killian. I still can win this game. That is a thing that can happen. So, I can't play the Dusk Mage and make this fly. So if I go to 15... Oh man. It's not gonna work. And they have two big stuff here going on. And that's assuming they have nothing in here. Yeah, that was just too good. Stuff they had. They never run out of cards. I guess the burying books on my... Yeah, promising Dusk Mage. That was the kind of back-breaking moment in this game. Because even if I go to 15, they have a lethal attack. And if I block with the Stone Rise Spirit... Although they need to... I mean, no matter what, I have to do this. This is like a given, right? Because I need to try to win next turn, because they have to leave 2 blockers here now. Okay. That's enough. Because my plan here was that I will just... Because if they... Let's say they had nothing there, they just scry here. They go to 3 here. And then that means that... I will be at 15. And then there, if they attack with like all the power in the battlefield they had currently was... 10, well, this just triggered, so it was actually 4 power, 10, 14, 16, 17, so I could jump block the Scurried Colony and survive, because I would be at 15, and they also couldn't attack with all of them, because they need 2 blockers for the Killian, and they would be at 3, so they would leave the 1-1 and the 2-2 to block. But they still would win with any Magecraft trigger, because I would have to block anyway. Or they can deal with... They could have dealt 15 with all of this stuff if this got 1 trigger. Assuming this, they didn't have the Arcane Subtraction, but they had, like, you know, nothing for this turn. So it was a very small chance to win. I guess I could have drawn a, you know, removal spell, and that would be easier. Would have been easier, but yeah. Anyway, it was a tough one. I mean, I'm still happy about the 2-1 result, but of course, it was very close to get a 3-0 result too. But you can't get them just by wanting them. Even though the deck had a couple of these things, I think there were enough cards to give it counters that it wasn't that bad. I guess something like Humiliate or Beaming Defiance here would have been just such a you know, crucial thing, countering the Burying Books they had there, for example. Or, you know, even now on this turn, countering the Arcane Subtraction, which I could have done, because this would have cost only 1 mana, so I had the mana to make the Killian fly and then cast this for 1 mana. I had 5 mana available, so this would have countered the Arcane Subtraction and gave me 2 additional life with Killian. So their attacks, I maybe didn't have to block with the Stone Rise Spirit. So yeah, I had the cards in the deck to deal with the situation. Like, even something like a Closing Statement would have just, you know, have been good enough. D-Spark also. So a lot of good cards could have been drawn there that would have helped me, but I just didn't get any of that. So another 2-1, but it's fine. I will see you in the next draft. Thank you for watching, and bye-bye.